Welcome dear all in our YouTube channel LHS Project and myself Professor Moinshu, and today we will see a new hardware setup. Title name is IoT based car engine or vehicle engine monitoring system. So hardware setup is as available on your screen, you can see. So before turning on, let's see scenario components one by one. So you can see first, it is a main switch, and main switch is used to turn on and off the entire system, okay, as you can understand. And next is we are using a power adapter here, 5 volt power adapter, to provide power to all these systems, okay, as you know. And next component, it's a Wi-Fi module, or we can say Node MCU module, okay. It is actually removable, so you can see we are using this module to send data from hardware to server. As it is an IoT project, so you can understand it is removable for study purpose. Next component, so we are using one smoke sensor here to check either the what is the smoke level in the engine, okay, as you can understand. It is also removable, as you can see it is actually one MQ135 smoke sensor, okay. So you can see. So next component is we are using one Arduino Nano. It is actually the main brain of the system, and it is responsible to handle entire operation like taking sensor data and processing the data and sending the commands to LCD. All of this is responsible for this Arduino Nano. Next component is here's one 16x2 LCD, and its purpose is to display all the parameters like smoke, temperature, speed of the engine, and vibration of the engine, each and everything we will see here, as well as at the same time on IoT server. And it is also removable, as you can understand, for study purpose or maintenance purpose, so we can replace it easily and place it here. Next is a sensor here, you can see fuel sensor. So by using this ultrasonic sensor, we can check the level of fuel sensor live on the screen, so you can understand it is the level sensor ultrasonic. Next component is a vibration sensor here to check the engine vibration level. We are using one vibration sensor here, and it is monitoring engine temperature is so important, so to fulfill that purpose, we are using one here temperature sensor here. Consider car engine is placed here, so we are placing. The next component is we are using one buck converter here to control the speed of the car, okay. Student can write their names here using the pen, okay, according to the group members. And here also they can write the guide name, so that so after doing all the arrangements, so time to turn on the project. So as you can see, I'll press on. So let's turn on main switch, and you can see project name is appearing on the screen. And we can see all the parameters, actually it is a field. So after turning on the project, we will use this laptop to see the IoT data. It's time to visit IoT server. For this, we can use any kind of web browser, so we will use Chrome browser here, okay, and entering the browser, and we can search here Adafruit.io, okay, you can see, and we can click enter. And after this page, we can click on this link, first link, okay. And when you will reach here, you will need to log in using the ID and password provided by us, okay. And you can visit to the dashboard, and then you can click on the project name in the dashboard, and you can see all the parameters here, okay, in this way, okay. But as you can understand, it is an IoT project, so we need to connect the system to hotspot to see the IoT parameters live. After doing all the arrangements, now we will connect our project to the personal hotspot. For this, we will use this cell phone, okay, and we will visit to the personal hotspot settings. So you can see it is here, okay. Every phone has different kind of settings, and we will click on this, and we will edit the settings, okay. All the projects have different settings, so remember, and it is I'm putting here for the example only, okay. After writing the personal hotspot name and settings, okay, remember, we will provide it after a few by the setups. We will provide all the settings, and we need to put it in the hotspot settings, and we can save it, okay, remember. And after 4 to 5 seconds, your project will automatically connect here, and it will show your connection management devices, okay. So you can see currently car is off, okay. I have placed one box here to avoid this putting it to the floor. Okay, so let's turn on the car. Here is the car speed controller, so it is currently in minimum position. So let's turn on the car using this switch. If you see, it is showing each and every parameters. See, remember the refresh time is 10 seconds for each engine. Fuel levels are conditioning. It is around 1 liter, you can see. And vibration is currently zero. And you can see temperature is 33.9 degrees C. Well, let's check it. Temperature is 33 degrees C. It is showing, and it is here is the graph of the system. And our smoke level is 273 now, you can see. 273 now, smoke level here. Okay, here is the graph of the smoke level. And here is the speed of the car. See, 557, 557. Okay, so it is running fine. And you can see currently fuel level is around 1 or 0. Okay, and here is the vibration level is also 0 because the car is running slowly now. So let's increase the car speed using this knob. So car speed is increased, so you can see speed is we will see new speed here after some time. So wait for it. See, current speed 919. So you can see 990. Here 990 speed, you can see graph is increased up. Okay, and also we will see smoke vibration level is increasing and decreasing because depending upon the car condition. Okay, so again let's check the speed, the car speed. So you can see this increased the car speed. So we will see new reading here after some time. See, car speed is increased. We can see again, here is the graph. Check, N1 and N1 essentially available engines, so you can see N1 91, yep, and it is showing the graph there, increased. I'm going to reduce the car speed again, so you can listen the voice. See, it is increased, decreased or decreased, so we will see the reading here. Around 500 to 600. See, okay, car level speed decreased, you can see in the graph. Okay, so now we will test the fuel level sensor. So currently you can see readings are around 0. Okay, also you can see it is showing 0 here. So here is some amount of water, we will put it inside it. Okay, so that we can see the performance of fuel sensor. So let's put some amount of water in this. So I have filled some new oil. Okay, so let's test what is the reading now. So you can see reading has increased though. Okay, it is showing 2 liters here, and you can also see here. Okay, reading has increased. So again we will put some amount of water in it so that we could. So you can see it is showing currently fuel level is around 4 liter. Okay, okay, it is showing the fuel level is around 4 liters here. Okay, and also we can see it is increased. Okay, from here it is a sensor using this gas lighter. Okay, you can see. So let's check what is the current temperature level. So you can see current temperature level is 33 degrees C. Okay, and graph is constant. Okay, because now we have not applied anything. So let's apply the fire to the temperature sensor here. We apply. So we will see any reading here after some time. Okay, let's see 34.8 degrees C it is showing. So you can see reading has increased from 32 to 34. So let's again put some amount of it. So we will see reading here after some time. See 39.5 degrees. See, again you can see the increase in graph. Okay, 39 here. And here is the 29. So it is working fine. Now time to test the smoke sensor. So you can see smoke sensor readings are 280 currently now pp. Okay, outside showing on the server live 280. Okay, so we will use this stick to provide smoke to the sensor and see its performance. So you can see I have applied it near the sensor, so we can see sensor rating has increased to 588. You can see 588. Okay, you can see the sudden increase in the smoke. You can see. Okay, so let's again apply. We will apply smoke to the sensor. So you can see. Okay, forward rating was 533. See, current rating is 796. You can see graph is increasing now. Okay, from 489 to 580. I currently reduced a little bit. Okay, so 700 rating is showing. It means our sensor is working so fine. After applying the smoke, you can see our reading has increased. So each and every setting is working so fine. Thank you so much for watching the video. We will see you in the next video. Take care.